riverbank. Do the job there, and then come back out to Oakdale for our third and last job of the day. So I don't believe, if I remember right, I haven't been to the second one. I have been to the third one for an estimate. That one's gonna be pretty well set up for us. Not gonna be empty from my understanding, but it will be cleared out as much as it needs to be so we can get it taken care of. So we'll be prepping to sell the house. Found us originally, but definitely happy they gave us the opportunity to clean for them. Seems not in bad shape really at all. Just thought it's a little loose. There's some normal traffic where we're out in the country right now. I'm still gonna move the cable out of the way at the same time here, so excuse my movements being sporadic here. A little stains, nothing major. Client was telling me that they accidentally tripped and spilled some paint in here, and they got it all up. Like, it looks like you wouldn't even know any better without them telling you. I told her, I was like, I'm glad you did that, because if she was holding a gallon of paint, the likelihood that it would all come out if it was a big splattered spot and it was dried up becomes a little much harder to do. Totally, that was an awesome. Alright guys, I have no idea where I left off speaking to you. I apologize for that. I got a phone call, and thankfully I booked another job. How awesome is that? And to top it off, the original service that she was looking for, we don't no longer do. And then I mentioned, oh yeah, we're no longer doing that service. Is something we did a long time ago to get started. She heard about us through somewhere, and so I was like, yeah, we're just doing carpet cleaning, house cleaning, tile upholstery, dryer vents and such. And she's like, oh, I need my carpet cleaned. So I got that scheduled, put on the books. So now between that and another call I got before we guys started filming, filled up a day. So I'm very thankful for that. Pretty much just about filled it completely up this morning already. And I'm very blessed to say that we are basically booked out 2 full weeks now. So this is why I've been mentioning that we're getting a second van, because when you're starting to be constantly booked out a week and a half, 2 weeks, there's days where I'm denying work because I can't get to it in the time that they want, you know, because they need it done within 2-3 days or whatever the case may be. You know, it's understanding if you got a party or something coming up, or you know, you're like, I really need to get it done ASAP. And you know, we're sitting here 2 weeks on average out. So that's why I've been bringing up the second van a bunch and lately, and basically can't wait to get it because of that. So that way I can have a route for Adam to do on his own, which he's more than ready for and has done a couple days on his own. And then I can be out taking care of those jobs that come in kind of more last minute. As my goal has been to get him solidly booked and constantly working. And then all the extra stuff that comes in, I'll take care of. And we'll go from there. Then we'll grow that and kind of repeat the process. Than the whole idea. Let's get the second van, get that up and running, grow it to a point where I once again need a helper riding with me and doing what Adam's doing right now, which is he's already, since I got on a phone call for about 8 minutes or so, he's in the other room where I already ran the CRB cleaning those. So that's basically what I'm trying to do. And then once that van's rolling on its own, right, Adam will move into that one. And then the new hire will move into the current one that we're using. Some kick out. We are out in the country. Remember I said that. So we're starting to get some dropout of the CRB here. But yeah, new hire will move into this current van, and then Adam will move into the one I'm waiting to get. And then and at some point I'll start managing a little bit more, doing jobs here and there, keeping videos going as much as I can. And then, again, probably repeat the process. If you get a third van, we'll see what happens. I've always wanted to be at least a 3-van operation, because right now we're doing really well. And I want to keep that momentum going. master bedroom, so I'm not surprised if it was kicked out in this section of the house. It for the CRB. So, got the kick out near the closet area. Sometimes there's some small little items that are stuck in the carbon fibers, and if you break it up, you can use a key, or if you have a, usually called carpet shark, it's got some jagged edges on there so you can start to break stuff loose, and then it makes it easier to rinse it out, obviously, if you have it broken up. But if it's all hardened up in a little piece, then a lot of times it won't pop out until you do so. Sometimes you can use, if it's a bigger chunk, you can use a razor blade to cut the stuff up a little bit, break it up, kind of like how he's doing with his fingers, and then after that, it usually has a tendency to vacuum out and rinse out a lot faster. Otherwise, he'd be going over it for quite a while, hoping that the heat would break it down. And depending on what it is, that sometimes can take quite some time, obviously over wetting the carpet, and then you have to spend a lot more time drying that area, whereas doing what he just did is going to significantly drop the amount of time it takes to get it out, rather than just running heat on it and that's it. A lot of times it would take 2-3 times longer just rinsing, hoping that the heat will break it down. But sometimes stubborn little spots like this just take some time, and you just gotta break it away from the carpet fibers in order to get it out. this area, I explained to the client, the carpet is a little loose. This is a rental. They're not thinking that the carpet's going to last past the next tenant. Because I did suggest that it needs to be stretched if you want to get rid of the ripples. I mean, it's very minimal, but over time it may get worse because it's right at the kitchen area. Alright everybody, we are all done here. So here's what the living room shaped up to look like. Did really well. All the other rooms did the same. No issues. On to the next one. Last job of the day. This room's empty, and then the rest of the rooms have some furniture in it. Adam is starting to free spray some of the other areas. But I already vacuumed. We got some discolorations here. There's some furniture stains. I just moved some stuff. And there was some marks there on the carpet. I believe when I was here doing an estimate, they were telling us that the previous cleaners moved it and didn't put some tabs or blocks underneath it, so it left marks on the carpet, which is common with wood furniture that has a finish and metal for rust. So anytime that you clean directly under a leg, you want to block it. Unless the only time you can get away with it and not be a problem, if it's a skinny plastic leg. But anytime you start to get a bigger base, you gotta run a block underneath it so the carpet can air out properly. And obviously so you don't leave a mark on the floor. Not too often that we run into those, but occasionally we do, from either something that spilled or somebody cleaned under it and didn't elevate the furniture. We got light color carpet with some stains throughout and some discolorations. See one right here in front of the, where I got the light of this on. Looks like something was used there to try and get something out and may not have been extracted, so that's why it looks brighter there. It's starting to bleach the color out of the carpet. That's why it's always good to use at least like a wet dry shop vac, or if you have a small portable extractor, to work that stuff out. So even soap residue on the carpet can definitely discolor it, especially over-the-counter stuff. I've come to find out that happens frequently. You put soap in the carpet and you don't pull it out, you know, attract dirt and probably cause these brighter spots like that to appear. Pulling the color.